Hi, this is JP from Not the Lights Over Arkham. This time we are playing Nathaniel Cho with the 19 experience deck, and I am playing the Curse of the Rougharou scenario. So I haven't played a lot of Nathaniel yet. I've only played the pre-built deck actually, and one game with a constructed deck just to see if you can solo game Nathaniel, because Nathaniel is mainly a fighter and not that good at getting clues, so my experience with Nathaniel is not that great in true solo, but we will try our best to defeat this scenario. If you haven't played Curse of the Rougharou before, there are a couple of ways to win the scenario, and one of them is just punching the Rougharou out, so to speak. We will see if we can do the more difficult way, but if not, I at least try to defeat the Rougharou. So let's look at Nathaniel's deck first. We have spent 19 experience to build the deck, just so that I can get some key cards in that will help us to set up faster and have some key cards under the stick to the plan from the get-go. We have one copy of emergency cash level 2, so we can draw cards and get resources with that, and then of course ever vigilant to set up an ally and maybe the boxing gloves at one action and cheaper. And of course one of the cards I really teched into this scenario is the Righteous Hunt, because with that we can close the gap between us and the Rougharou when the Rougharou is darting across the board, so we can more easily catch up to the Rougharou. We have included two copies of boxing gloves level 3, and also one copy of Charisma. So that is all of the experience cards. Other than that, we have Greta Wagner, guard dog, and of course Randall Cho as the allies. Then we have one copy of backpack level 0. This is just because the boxing gloves are so important for Nathaniel and his deck. We want to have an extra card to fetch the boxing gloves faster if we don't get them in the starting hand. So we have a chance with the backpack if we get that instead. Then the events, we have quite usual Nathaniel events, so a lot of the spirit events. We have counter punches, dodges, then we have for some clue tech evidence and scene of the crime. Then we have glory, 1-2 punch, and that is it. Then we also included a bit more help to the investigation with two copies of perception. Then we have steadfast, take the initiative, and vicious blow. Because this is 19 experience deck, we have two basic weaknesses. The first one is drawing the sign, and the second one is hypochondria. So maybe not that bad, but we'll see how they function in this deck. Of course, Nathaniel's signature weakness, Tommy Malloy, is quite a nuisance. You basically lose your whole turn beating that guy up, because you can't inflict multiple wounds per hit on him. But that is basically the deck. Nothing really fancy. As I said, I haven't played Nathaniel that much, so we'll see how this goes, and I'll try to do my best and enjoy the game, even if it ends up in a defeat. But that is Arkham, so let's get started. So we have set up the scenario. The encounter deck and player deck have been shuffled. In setup, we put Righteous Hunt, Emergency Cash, and Ever Vigilant underneath the stick to the plan. I'll just keep them at the side here, so it's easier for me to grab the cards I'm using. At the setup, we picked one random location type, so we hit the riverside, and also we removed the unhallowed locations from the locations. So we have Wilderness and New Orleans left, which will come into play later. So we start at Parkis Waters. It's a one-shot location with zero clues. While you are at Parkis Waters, you cannot play assets. Action: discard two assets from your hand or from play. Test agility 3 to wade through the dark waters and retrieve an abandoned fishing net. If you succeed, take control of the set aside fishing net asset. Because we really have so few assets in the deck, I think we might just skip that. And first off, let's see what is our opening hand. Okay, so that is shuffled. That is shuffled. So we get Steadfast, Dodge, 1-2 Punch, Perception, and the Boxing Gloves. So we will keep the Boxing Gloves. And I think I'll try to fish out one of the allies so I can utilize the Ever Vigilant better. So I will just mulligan all of these. So we get Evidence, take the initiative, Vicious Blow, and Grete Wagner. So this is actually perfect. Now we can move, play Ever Vigilant, play Grete and the Boxing Gloves for 5 resources. So the Ever Vigilant will cheapen Grete to 4 and the Boxing Gloves to 1. So that is actually perfect for the first turn. So then we have our Boxing Gloves out, so we can start punching all of the enemies that might turn up, and also we have Grete to grab some clues while we're at it. So I'll just quickly shuffle the player deck, then set this aside. First action, we will move to Riverside location, so because we can't play assets here, so we'll just move here. And we find the Faubourg Marigny. It's a 4-strat location with 0 clues, Riverside. While you are at Faubourg Marigny, reduce the cost of each asset you play by 1, so even better. And there is a resign here, so we can get out of the scenario if we do badly there. So, second action, I will exhaust, sticks to the plan. I will play Ever Vigilant, which will let us play 3 assets as a one action, and they are 1 cheaper. So this cheapens them and this cheapens them. So the Boxing Gloves are free. And Grete is only 3 resources, so pretty good. And last action, there's no point in staying here, so last action we'll just move to the other Riverside location. It's the Audubon Park. Audubon Park, actually. It's one clue location with Shroud of 3. Riverside Forest. When you evade an enemy at Audubon Park, discard a random card from your hand. That is not that bad because we are not evading. We will actually try to investigate here next turn. So that is our turn, no enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw a card. We get another take the initiative, really good. And we gain 1 resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom to the agenda. It has a threshold of 5, so 1 of 5. Then counter card for this turn is Ripples in the Surface. Test willpower 3. For each point you fail by, take 1 horror. If you are at a bayou location, you cannot commit cards to this skill test. So for each point you fail by, we really don't want to take a lot of horror this early on. So I'll commit to take the initiative to this test. So I'm testing 6 versus 3. We It's a zero, so we pass, so no four taken. First action, we will actually play the other, take the initiative. So we are investigating. We get three from that, so we are investigating five versus three. And it's a skull. Skulls are minus two, minus four instead if you are at the bayou location. And might as well say that the cultists are minus two and something about the Rougharou. And tablets are reveal another token, and the elder thing is a minus four and something about the Rougharou, but we'll see them more when we hit those. So we grab this clue. And second action, I think we are using the emergency cash this turn. So we grab three resources and also draw a card, and we find glory. Then I'll move for my last action back to the brackish waters, so we can actually spend the clue. So only investigators at the bayou location may spend the required number of clues to group to advance. So we'll spend the clue to get forward in the scenario. Understanding the curse. So put the set aside Lady Esprit into play at the bayou location. Put into play each set aside location. Put the set aside the Rougharou enemy in play at any non-bayou location. Shuffle the encounter discard pile, and each encounter card from the curse of the Rougharou encounter set into the encounter deck. The lead investigator reads the following out loud. Well, fluff text, and the lead investigator puts the set aside curse of the Rougharou weakness into play in his or her threat area. So I will pause the video for a bit, do the mid-game setup, and we'll continue from there, so I'll be right back. Okay, well, we have set up the map and all of the rest, so a little change. I actually will do the advancing in the upkeep phase, so let's gain a resource and draw a card before that. Then we do all of the rest, because this would deal us a horror if we did it before the end of our turn. So we get the curse of the Rougharou. So at the end of your turn, if you have not dealt any damage this turn, take one horror. And we place the Rougharou to New Orleans, and we will need to go there and try to hit the Rougharou. So let's look at the Rougharou quickly. Rougharou is 3 fight, 5 health, 3 evade, monster, creature, elite, aloof, retaliate. As an additional cost for an investigator to engage Rougharou, the investigator must spend one clue as a group, two clues instead of three or four in an investigator game. Fourth, after the Rougharou takes one damage per investigator during a single phase, find the location that is the farthest from all investigators, move the Rougharou one location at a time until it reaches, enters that location. So we need to try to hit it as hard as possible and deal more than one damage, because otherwise we have to keep running around after it, and the aloof is annoying because we can't engage it without clues, so we need to get clues to engage it and etc. So that is basically the turn. Let's look at Lady Esprit. So we can, as an action, exhaust Lady Esprit and deal her one horror, heal two damage, or gain two resources. Any investigator at Lady Esprit's location may activate this ability. So Lady Esprit will mark this over here, so we know where we can heal a bit if we need to. But no enemy actions, and we did the upkeep and the mid-game setup, so let's go to the next turn. This should be also ready to We are at 2 Doom of 5, and the encounter deck got the Rougharou set in it, so there should be a lot more enemies here. So let's see what is the encounter card. Ripples in the surface. Test willpower 3. For each point you fail by, take 1 horror. If you are at a bayou location, you cannot commit cards. So we are at a bayou location, so we can't commit anything. We are just testing 3 versus 3 and hoping for the best. And this could be a really short game if we keep hitting these all the time. But that is the scenario. It's not really easy on a true solo, and especially with the Nathaniel. It's a minus 4, so that means we'll take 3 horror, and I will split it between Nathaniel and Greta. Well, nothing we can do about that. So, just to remind, we still need to pay the clue for engaging, so we just can't play this right away now. So we'll need to find the clue first. We'll save that for later. So first action, we don't have anything here to utilize. So we'll just move and we'll go here. So we find the Cursed Shores. It's a one-shot location with 0 clues, take 1 damage. You get plus 2 to your skill value for the next skill test you make this turn. Post, when you leave Cursed Shores, choose and discard a skill card from your hand. That is not really nice, because we... Well, we have a choice of Vicious Blow or Perception, and I think I'll discard the Perception. Keep moving. So let's go over here first. So we find the Broadmoor. It's a 3-shot location with 1 clue, action, resign, and victory point 1. So we'll try to get this clue from here. And last action, we'll actually commit glory and evidence. Actually, we really need the clue, so we'll commit both. So we are testing 6 versus 3. It's a plus 1, so we grab this clue. And that is our turn, and we didn't deal a damage, so we'll take 1 horror. That is going to kill us if we won't start dealing damage soon. So we will upkeep, so we draw a card and gain 1 resource. And that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, and I really hope we hit an enemy and not a card that deals horror. So dragged under. Test agility 3. If you fail, add dragged under to your threat area. When you leave your current location, take 2 damage and discard dragged under. Post at the end of your turn, test agility 3, if you succeed, discard trapped under. So we're just testing 2 versus 3, probably failing this. It's a minus 3, so we fail. And then we just leave the location, so we take 2 damage. Nothing much we can do about that. So we'll move here. And it is the Garden District. It is one shroud location with 0 clues. Test agility 7 to try to break into a nearby greenhouse and take a look around. If you succeed, remember that the investigators have found a strange doll. So we are not doing that. Just checking. So, when you deal damage to an enemy by an event or a fight ability on an event, deal 1 additional damage, limit once per phase. So this would have been a good point to have the glory, but it is what it is. We'll just punch. So, second action, we will engage the Rougharou. And we'll spend the clue. Then I am committing the Vicious Blow. and hitting. So we are hitting 5, 6 versus 3. It's a plus 1, so we deal 2 damage. And the Rougharou will dart off. So every location the Rougharou leaves, Rougharou drops a clue. So it drops one here, drops one here. And let's go here, so drops one here. And can just choose, let's go here. So it doesn't actually drop a clue there. So the Rougharou runs off to here. And now we have dealt damage, so we are not taking any horror from this. And that is our turn. So there are no enemy actions, so we'll ready draw one card, and we get perception, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, and we add a doom, so 4 or 5 encounter card is Spectral Mist. Add that to a Bayou location, limit 1 per location, each skill test performed at attached location gets plus 1 difficulty. And test Intellect 2 to disturb the source of the mist. If you succeed, discard them. This, so I'll just place it over here. Just put it like this, so we are probably not heading there anytime soon, so not a problem. First action. Let's see. So the Righteous Hunt is up to 2 locations away, so we really don't have. I think we'll try to just grab a couple of clues here and accept the horror. So first action, we'll use perception to investigate here. So I am investigating 4 versus 1. Plus 1, so we grab this clue. We also draw a card with the perception, and we get 1-2 punch, which is really good. That will actually help a lot. We could try to end the scenario next turn. Second action, we will move, and third action, we will move. So after you leave here, we don't have any skill cards, so we don't discard anything. So we head to the Forgotten Marsh. So, 2 Shroud, 0 clues, forced. When you leave Forgotten Marsh, lose 2 resources. That is okay, we have plenty of resources to lose. And, of course, we defeat the Rougharou, we get resolution 2, but we could also advance this and see what the other goal is, but I think we can just forget about that because there is so little ways to get those items needed with Nathaniel, because most of them need agility and we really are not packing agility here. And yeah, that is the actually. Yeah, I think that is our turn. No enemy actions, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get glory, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Oh yeah, and we took a horror. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We advance the agenda, so this might mess up our plans, but we'll see. So Darkened Skies. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. If the Rougharou is in play, find a non-value location with the fewest clues on it. Move the Rougharou 1 location at a time until it enters that location. If the Rougharou is not in play, advance. After advancing to agenda 2A, add 1 doom to the agenda. Well, we just move the Rougharou, and this is a non-value location with 0 clues, so let's just move the Rougharou there. And as it leaves, it drops one clue here. Then we'll shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. And just hope that we don't hit that one treachery. Okay, so the encounter card for this turn is Cursed Swamp. Hazard test, willpower 3. For each point you fail by, take 1 damage. If you are at a bio location, you cannot commit cards, so this is quite annoying. So 3 versus 3. It's a cultist, it's a minus 2. If the Rougharou is in your location, reveal another token. Well, the Rougharou isn't, so we just fail, and we fail by 2, so we take 2 damage. I think Nathaniel can handle the damage. That is the Mythos phase. We will use the stick to the plan to play the Righteous Hunt. So, engage. Choose an enemy up to 2 locations away. Move 1 location at a time to that enemy's location, engage it, and add blessed tokens to the chaos bag equal to the enemy's horror value. So the horror value is 2, so we add 2 blessed tokens to the chaos bag. We will move to the location we leave here, so we lose 2 resources. And we find the Twisted Underbrush. So 3 shroud, 1 clue, gain 1 resource and take 1 horror. Gain 2 resources and take 1 horror action, which I think we don't need. So we are engaging the Rougharou. We have to spend the clue to engage it. And there is 1 clue here. So that was the first action. Second action, we will 1-2 punch. So now I have to actually check the timing. So during a single phase, find location. Okay, so I think we, well, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think we, if we hit with this, we will win, because we are dealing 3 damage, and that is all we need to defeat the Rougharou. So first we have to hit. If we hit, then we will hit again and get plus 1 damage, which we should be enough. We'll see. So yeah, we'll play the 1-2 punch. Then I'll commit boxing gloves to the test. Actually, I'll commit it to this first one. So I am hitting 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 versus 3. So even the minus 6 won't fail us. It's a cultist. We reveal another token. Minus 3, that is still enough, so we deal 1 damage, and then we get to fight again. And now we get plus 2 and plus 1 damage, so we are... Oh yeah, and I've been forgetting the plus 2 from the boxing gloves, so 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 versus 3. So we are just KOing this Rougharou. It's a plus 1, so... That is game. We will deal 2 damage, defeating the Rougharou, and we will advance to resolution 2. So that was actually quite a fast game. I was not expecting it to be that fast, but we get resolution 2. We would record that the Rougharou is destroyed and the curse is lifted. Remove the curse of the Rougharou weakness from its bearer's deck. Anyone investigator may choose to add Lady Esprit to his or her deck. This card does not count towards the investigator deck size. And we get the experience, but this is a standalone, so... Yeah, we were pretty near getting defeated by horror. This scenario is infamous of dealing a lot of horror with this, and with those encounter cards we got twice. So this is still a fun scenario. I rarely play it solo because it's usually quite fast or you get defeated really fast. So I just noticed that I haven't played this on my channel yet, so that is why I chose this scenario. And it's still a good scenario, and I highly recommend picking up the standalone scenario pack if you have the chance. But yeah, that was Nathaniel Cho in the Curse of the Rougharou. So hope you guys liked this playthrough. Thanks for watching, and until next time.